Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will discuss types of communication and level of communication. If you are new, it is recommended that you first see the lecture that cover communication and its process. Types of communication. Number one, formal communication. Number two, informal communication. Communication in an organization may be either external or internal. External communication concerned with correspondence with those outside the organization. Internal communication is concerned with communication within the organization. Internal communication can be classified into different communication like downward, upward, horizontal, grapevine. Formal communication. Downward, upward, horizontal, diagonal communication is formal communication. In this type of communication, information, circulars, and notices are passing through levels in a formal style. Downward communication starts from higher authority to downward authority, like the board of directors to managers, purchase officer to executive clerk, etc. It is a convenient channel to explain policies and organizational procedure to appraise the subordinates for their performance. Major decisions are conveyed through this type of communication. It is necessary for the functioning of any organization as it involves the transfer of information, instruction, advice, requests, feedback, and ideas to subordinate staff. It is useful for appraisal of the subordinates for their performance. Downward communication is very long and time-consuming process. Downward communication is too much authoritarian process. Upward communication. Upward communication starts from the bottom level to top level. For example, workers convey messages to production manager, he conveys it to the director of company, etc. Upward communication provides necessary feedback. Upward communication is also important for workers' suggestions for the welfare of an organization. Upward communication is difficult as it moves upward against the force of gravity, it means workers hesitate to initiate for upward communication. Workers at the lowest level are not efficient communicators, so their communication, oral or written, may not be accurate or may not be welcomed by supervisor. It may also include innovative idea, reactions to the particular policy, rules, or a behavior of any person on the job. Horizontal communication. Horizontal communication refers to the flow of communication among the people at the same level of authority. The main objectives of horizontal communication are developing teamwork and promoting group coordination within an organization. Horizontal communication is less formal. Sometimes it results into gossip about management. Diagonal or crosswise communication. Communication between departments or employees in the same organization without an hierarchy is called diagonal communication. It is the most used channel of communication. Workers communicate with other workers, colors sharing information with one another. Managers discuss some organizational problems are all engaged in diagonal communication. Diagonal communication is extremely important for promoting understanding and coordination among various departments. Now, next is informal communication. Informal channels transmit official news through unofficial and informal communicative interactions known as the grapevine. This informal communication network includes tea time gossip, casual gatherings, lunchtime meeting, and so on. Grapevine communication is the best example of informal communication. Grapevine communication. An informal channel of communication in an organization is called grapevine. For example, people working together take interest in one another and talk about appointment, promotions, demotions, or even domestic and romantic affairs of another. It follows no set lines or any definite rules, but spread very fast in any direction. Grapevine communication provides much needed release to emotions. One of the major limitations of the grapevine is that it may spread baseless news which may harm the employees. Grapevine communication is not always negative. for an organization and can be helpful because it helps in positive group building. It may help in building up organizational solidarity and harmony. It provides much needed release to emotions. Any information in the name of secret spreads very fast. It provides feedback for management. Levels of communication. Human communication takes place at various levels. Extrapersonal communication, intrapersonal communication, interpersonal communication, organizational communication, and mass communication. Extrapersonal communication. It is a communication between human being and non-human being. This requires perfect coordination between sender and receiver. When our pet dog comes to you wagging its tail as soon as you return home is an example of extrapersonal communication. Intrapersonal communication. This communication occurs within the individual's brain in the form of internal dialogue. For example, when you feel hot, the information is sent to brain and you may decide to turn on the cooler. Responding the instructions sent from brain to hand, here relevant organ is sender. Electrochemical impulse is message and brain is receiver. Next, the brain assumes the role of sender and sends the feedback that you should switch on the cooler. So this process can be termed as intrapersonal communication. Number 3, interpersonal communication. It is a sharing of information among people. It includes a few participants who are close to one another. Here, many sensory channels are used and immediate feedback can be obtained. This can assume in the form of face-to-face conversation, video conferencing, and telephonic talk, and soon it takes place in our day-to-day life. Organizational communication. Communication in an organization takes place at different levels. It may be upward, downward, diagonal, and grapevine. This kind of communication can be divided into interoperational communication, contains the structure communication within the organization. B. External operation communication deals with people and group outside the organization. It is the organization's communication with its public, its suppliers, customers, and general public. C. Personal communication, communication that occurs without purpose as far as business is concerned is called personal communication. Number 5, mass communication. There are several mass media such as journals, televisions, newspapers, internet, which mediate such communication to the large audience. Information in the oral form requires equipment such as microphones, amplifiers, and information in the written form requires electronic or print media. Oral communication through mass media requires some equipment such as microphones, amplifiers, etc. And the written form requires of print visual media. So in this lecture, we discussed types of communication and levels of communication. If you still have some queries, please write back an email. I will get back to you with the answers of your question in my next lecture. Thank you.